This is the sign of a club in crisis with a leadership so unpopular the entire executive board was warned to stay away from today's game. As Everton crashed into their ninth consecutive defeat, there were chants of sack the board. But no one from the board was here at Goodison Park. They'd been warned to stay away. A security team said it was not safe. In a statement, Everton FC said the board members received the instruction following malicious and unacceptably threatening correspondence received by the club and increasing incidents of antisocial behaviour, including targeted physical aggression at recent home matches. It has been quite an extraordinary day here at Everton FC, with that statement coming just a few hours before today's match against Southampton. The management say it has been a profoundly sad event for the club and its fans, but the fans we've spoken to say actually what they feel is anger. Everton has only won three games this season. Some small groups of fans looked to target their frustration at players, management and club staff as they left the stadium after tonight's defeat, meeting a strong police presence in response.
Very noticeable, and rightly so, I think. I think change is due, shall we say.
There shouldn't be situations like that where people are fearful of coming to a football match because they may be assaulted. That's ridiculous.
I'm cold, fed up, and that's it.
Everton's manager Frank Lampard conceded there is pressure.
It's a difficult period. There's so much passion at this club, you know, for various reasons and the right reasons. Everybody here at the club wants the best for the club. And of course, over years, we've come in this direction that now we're in relegation battle last year, relegation battle this year. So I think it's as much as I need to say on it tonight.
Everton's owner, Farhad Moshiri, says he stands by Frank Lampard as manager, but today's security warning is unprecedented in the club's history, with some fans saying it reflects just how toxic things have become. Katerina Vitozzi, Sky News, Liverpool.